Last night, I picked up a hooker in West Hollywood. I sure hope my wife doesn't find out. Now, here's your host, Conan O'Brien!
Thank you, all right, thank you very much, thank you, muchas gracias, danke schön, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to begin by thanking you for creating an expectation we cannot meet. All right. So anyway, that is our show. Thank you. As you can tell, ladies and gentlemen, the studio audience here in LA is incredibly pumped. We know that. But the reason, you should know, folks, the reason they're so excited is just before the show, Andy and I went around and gave each person in the audience a free lap dance, which they enjoyed. Which is nice, I thought. You had a good time. Let's talk. I know how to quiet you down. I'm gonna tell some monologue jokes. That'll get things real quiet. You'll like this. This is nice. During an internet chat the other night, you probably read this, President Clinton said that in the future, world leaders will have to deal with, quote, miniature weapons of mass destruction. That's what he said. Yeah. And after hearing this, Hillary said he already has a miniature weapon of mass destruction, which, you know, was nice. I got a little California story since we're in Los Angeles. This is nice. This week, you probably heard this, 9 California condors raised in captivity were released into their new home, the Grand Canyon. I thought that was, isn't that nice? Yeah, and if you're trying to spot the birds, the California condors are the ones with breast implants. They got the booby, which I think is nice. I like that one. You're gonna like this. Since we're in LA, I wanted to have some LA celebrity gossip. This was in the news. During a recent interview, Gary Coleman said, that's not the joke, Gary Coleman. Gary Coleman said that he is still a virgin. That's what he said. Yeah. Yeah, although Coleman did say he has been used several times as a vibrator. Which, now, I did want to do something before. We got a lot of comedy tonight. I did want to do something real, and this is real, that I'm going to do right now. This is not one of our made-up bits. This studio actually means a lot to me. Studio One in Burbank, this is where I auditioned. It's almost 7 years ago now, in April. This is where I auditioned for this job. And we thought we'd do something. Tonight that we've never done before. They taped the audition, and we've never shown it. And I thought, this isn't a joke. It's not a, this is not a piece of comedy. I just thought, enough time, you may find it so, but I just thought enough time has gone by that's kind of interesting to see what the hell, because some of our hardcore fans were like in grade school. Let's take a look. Let's take a look now at this clip. This is my actual audition tape, no kidding around, from almost 7 years ago. Take a look.
I like how models do that all the time. Because it right. is physically very hard work.
It's not that bad.
It's a, you've done a lot, okay.
I've done a lot of catalog stuff, mostly.
See, that it is hard work, long hours.
No, it seems, you know, like it would be hard. No, it doesn't. People always say that. People always say it's tough to be like a model. No, like turning a big crank
is
tough.
I'm not talking about that.
It is. First of all, again, thank you for coming.
How could I miss an opportunity like this?
It's not often you get to share camera time with me.
There you go.
That's the end of my mock show. If that's all I ever get, it was a lot of fun. I had a good time. Thank you very much. Good night.
They clearly chose the wrong guy. Well, whatever. I bought a suit since then. Folks, we have an amazing show tonight. We have an incredible show, huge lineup from the upcoming movie, End of Days, Arnold Schwarzenegger. Arnold! Oh. We also, feels good. We also have, from a little show I like to call Friends, Lisa Kudrow. And one of our favorite comedians on the show, Dana Gould, gonna join us. Funny guy. And right over there, Jimmy Vivino and the seven Max Weinberg friends. Gentlemen.